The camp of President-elect Marcos bears more cabinet appointees. Former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile will be the next presidential legal counsel. Enrile served as Justice Secretary and Defense Minister during the Marcos Sr.'s administration. Enrile has accepted the nomination, saying he will devote his time and knowledge to the Republic. Outgoing Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara has also accepted the Solicitor General post, replacing Jose Calida. Meanwhile, retired General Jose Faustino Jr. has been tapped as the next defense secretary, but he will only assume the post on November 13 in compliance with a one-year ban on the appointment of retired military officers to government. Philippine National Police deploy surveillance teams to the National Museum, the venue for the June 30th inauguration of President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Over 4,000 police personnel are set to be mobilized on the day of the inauguration. Aside from securing the inaugural venue, they will also keep watch on Manila's so-called Freedom Parks, which are the designated venues for protests.
Kung may ito'y nakakaabala na sa daloy ng trapiko, naninira na ng mga kagamitan ng gobyerno. Wala tayong magagawa dyan kundi patupad natin ng stricto ang batas.
Violation yan mismo. Meron din na particular na provision doon sa batas sa pambasa 880 na hindi pa pwedeng ang sa English, ano, obstruct, impede, no? Or frustrate the free exercise. Hindi, halata naman kung gano'n ang gagawin nila. So ano yun, ino-obstruct agad ang tema, no? Yung malayang pagtitipon na mapayapa. No? So doon pa lang, eh, violation na yun. Sila mismo hindi na law enforcement yan, law violation na yan.
An economic advisor to Philippine President Duterte urges his successor to help attain the priority needs of small and medium enterprises. Joey Concepcion met with President-elect Marcos Jr. at his Mandaluyong headquarters Wednesday. Marcos agreed with Duterte's advisor for entrepreneurship on the crucial role of micro, small and medium enterprises in achieving prosperity for the Philippines.
It was a very good meeting. I was quite impressed with President-elect Marcos. It was the first time we met. It was a very warm discussion. We talked about basically the health, high prices, and of course the MSMEs. No? The trust and is really to help finance our MSMEs and ensure that they have access to money, no? Basically capital, so that they can restart, they can sustain their businesses.
Concepcion also said he warned Marcos about the impact of Russia's prolonged invasion of Ukraine on the Philippine economy.
There is no ending to this conflict. And the more prolonged this conflict gets, the worse the whole situation becomes. No? So that the repercussion here, I was telling him, is that consumers will be affected. You can see mobility somehow slowing down with less cars on the streets because gasoline prices of premium unleaded, I was told by my drivers, about 85, 89 pesos already per liter. That's more than double. And so many people will be, their spending will be reduced, and that may lead to further problems for the Philippine economy. So that was, I was telling him that while the pandemic is moving towards endemic, the greatest concern that we have right now is the high prices.
Concepcion notes they did not discuss whether he could stay on as presidential advisor for entrepreneurship. Philippine Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez tells President-elect Marcos to keep the taxes on oil. Dominguez says Marcos should not give in to calls for the suspension of excise tax on fuel products despite skyrocketing prices of global crude due to Russia's invasion of Ukraine. For Dominguez, the better way to address the impact of rising fuel prices is to provide swift and targeted support to vulnerable sectors. He asserts suspending the excise tax on fuel will reduce government revenues by nearly 106 billion pesos this year. Dominguez also clarifies there is no double taxation in the power industry. He was reacting to Energy Regulatory Commission head Agnes de Vanadera's statement, saying the next administration should remove the VAT on generation charges, claiming the tax must apply only to distribution charges. Philippine Central Bank not seeing stagflation as an immediate risk to the domestic economy. Stagflation happens when there is slow economic growth, high inflation, and high unemployment rate. The BSP remains optimistic the Philippines will sustain its economic recovery. It cited the country's stronger-than-expected GDP in the first quarter, a steady upturn in credit activity, and improving consumer confidence. It adds, while inflation is seen to remain elevated in the near term, it is expected to revert to government's target range of 2-4% by 2023. The BSP now calls for direct and targeted interventions by government to temper supply-side pressures. Inflation in the Philippines soared to 5.4% in May, driven by higher oil and commodity prices.